The truss shown in the figure has four members of length L and flexural rigidity EI and one member of length L root 2 and flexural rigidity 4 EI. The truss is loaded by a pair of forces of magnitude P as shown in the figure. This is the truss configuration where load P is acting at an angle 45 degrees in the opposite ends of the truss. Let us see what he is asking. The smallest value of P at which any of the truss members will buckle is. So basically, we need to find out the magnitude of P such that any one of the members in the truss configuration given can buckle. Okay, so let us go ahead and see the solution, how to solve this. This is a truss configuration. Now let us try to rename the joints as I, J, K, L as shown in the figure here. First, let us try to focus on joint I and let us try to resolve the force P which is acting at an angle 45 degrees at the joint I. Let us try to draw its free body diagram. Free body diagram of joint I is like this, where Fij is the force carried by the member Ij in the truss and Fil is force carried by the member Il in the truss. So P is resolved as P cos 45 towards left and P sin 45 towards top. So in this configuration, when we apply the force equilibrium, that is sum of horizontal forces is equal to 0 and sum of vertical forces is equal to 0, we get Fij is equal to P by root 2 and Fil is equal to P by root 2. So basically we have found out the forces carried by members Ij and Il using the method of sections. Similarly, let us try to calculate the forces carried by the members attached to the joint K. So let us try to draw the free body diagram of joint K by resolving the force P acting at joint K. So similarly here also, when we apply the force equilibrium, we get Fkj is equal to P by root 2 and Fkl is equal to P by root 2. Okay. Now let us try to consider the diagonal truss member, which is JL in our notation, and try to draw its free body diagram. So this is the free body diagram of truss member JL. So let us consider the joint J first. Since the member is FJL, it also has some force which is being carried by the applied force, because of applied force, which is FJL here. So when we consider joint J and its free body diagram, this is what we get. Force FJL is also resolved as FJL cos 45 towards left and FJL sin 45 towards down. So here, when we try to apply the force equilibrium, we get FJL is equal to minus P. So the maximum possible force which is exerted on the member JL is minus P. So the maximum possibility is that the member JL will buckle first. Okay, so the buckling load according to Euler's theory in columns and struts is pi square EI by L square, but given that the flexural rigidity of the member JL is 4 EI and its corresponding length is root 2 L, substituting that will give us 2 pi square EI by L square. So this is the correct option and it matches with option C.